Hi, I'm Vandana Mehrotra, and I would like to share my learnings when buying diamond and solitaires so that you can also make a conscious choice and a smart choice when buying such precious stones for a lifetime. So how to buy a solitaire? So I know every woman aspires to have a solitaire, but there are few techniques and tweaks that if you follow, you can save about approximately 20% from what you would generally pay when buying a solitaire. So solitaire starts from 19 cents and onwards, okay. And generally, when you go for buying a solitaire, if you buy a 25 cent, which is 1/4 carat, or a 50 cent, which is half a carat, or 75 cents, which is 3/4 of a carat, and 1 carat stone, you need to actually look into stone sizes which are not exactly these, but a little higher or lower than these. For example, look for a 22 cents. Or a 23 cents, or a 44 cents, or a 65 cents, or a 92 cents, or a 1.06 carat. Because if you do that, the prices of the solitaire come down by almost 20%. Okay. Now diamond is measured in volume, so it doesn't really make much difference in the size of the stone, but it makes a lot of difference in your pocket. Alright. So when you go for diamond, you always ask for these odd sizes, because it will help you save money. Now, as I said, there are four C's of diamond. I'll in another video, but I'll just give a quick review of that here as well. So the four C's of diamond are the cut, color, clarity, and carat. And in solitaires, you can exactly ask for one specific color, one specific clarity. So what is clarity of diamonds? Clarity of diamonds is the percentage of flaws found in the naturally found stone. Based on the percentage of these flaws, various clarities are defined. So the first best clarity is IF, internally flawless. Very difficult to find such stones in this timeline. So if somebody is offering you an IF kind of a solitaire, I suggest be better careful, do your R&D before paying a premium price for that product. The next best clarity is VVS. VVS stands for very, very slightly included diamonds, which means the flaws may or may not be visible under 10x magnification. So for a solitaire, you can ask for a VVS 1 or a VVS 2 clarity. The next clarity is VS, very slightly included diamonds. That means the flaws may be visible under 10x magnification. Again, VS 1, VS 2, and then the third category is slightly included SI, SI 1, SI 2. The flaws are visible, may or may not be visible with the naked eye. So what I'm saying is, either go for a VVS or a VS or SI. VVS 1, VVS 2, VS 1, VS 2, SI 1, SI 2. Okay. And the color band that you could ask is from D, E, F, G, H. I recommend these 5. Beyond this, don't even look, because the diamond starts looking pale yellow. It doesn't look like a diamond anymore. Okay. So D, E, F are almost colorless, you know, near colorless kind of colors. GH are whitish. Okay, so you can look at these color bands, and then the cut, based on cut, depends how light is reflected, and it is a game changer in your stone. So look for excellent cut, very good cut. Okay, so there are 5 cuts: excellent, very good, good, fair, poor. Okay, so make sure you are either buying an excellent cut or a very good cut stone. Okay. Even the polish and symmetry should be excellent or very good. Okay. So when you buy solitaires, on the certificate there are these 3 parameters: the cut, symmetry, polish. So it should be excellent. That's the best stone. Okay. And carat is the weight of the diamond, as I already discussed. Now see how the prices vary, and that's how as a customer you feel that, why somebody is giving me a diamond 1 carat stone in 2.5 lakh, somebody is asking me 4.5 lakh, somebody is asking me 6 lakh. So why so much variation in the price? Okay. So now there are 4 parameters of diamond we discussed: the cut, color, clarity, and carat. Now let's take an example. You are buying a 1 carat stone. Okay. 1 carat, and you chose VVS 1. Okay. Excellent cut, excellent polish, excellent symmetry. And the color you choose is D. Alright. Now the price of this diamond is, say, for example, okay, I'm going to say 6 lakhs for 1 carat. Okay. Now, the moment I change one of the parameter, the prices change by 7 to 8%, sometimes 10 to 12%. Okay. So now I see I have a VVS 1 carat stone. Quality is VVS 1. Color I made it E. Okay, from D to E. Rest all parameters remain the same. There will be a 7 to 8% variation in the price. Okay. Now I still keep the stone, 1 carat stone we are talking about. Clarity is VVS 1, and I make the color G. And rest everything remains the same. There will be 10 to 12% difference in the price. Now let's assume 1 carat, VVS 1, D color, and the cut I make it very good. Instead of excellent, I now make it very good. The price will vary by 7 to 8% from this price. Alright. So if you go for a VVS 2 D color, a price will be different. Right? And very good cut or excellent cut, whatever you choose based on that, the price will vary. So there are so many permutation combination. That's how the prices vary. So first decide what you want. Alright. Do you want a VVS 1 stone or a VVS 2 stone? VS 1 stone, VS 2 stone, SI 1 stone, SI 2 stone. Then define the color. Choose any color from D to H. It really doesn't matter too much, except it costs you too much. The look of this of your product more or less remains the same. Okay. So what my recommendation is, go for a VS 1 or VS 2 and go for F color or G color. That is I would buy like that. Okay? So it's not the best, it's not on the lower side, it's in between and it looks the best and it suits your pocket. Okay? So the takeaways from this session, never go for exact 25 cents or 50 cents or 75 cents or 1 carat. Look for near these values, it will help you save cost. You should exactly know what kind of stone you want. VVS 1, VVS 2, VS 1, VS 2, SI 1, SI 2, the color band. My recommendation is VS 1, VS 2, the color band GH. Okay, will do. Okay, all these products will still look the same. Okay, it will not hurt your pocket. Okay? And there is one more factor called fluorescence when you buy solitaire that should be accounted for. So either fluorescence is none or medium or slightly tainted. So what that factor means is when you are exposing the diamond to a particular frequency, it strongly emits one particular color or it does not emit any particular color. Now there are varying views on this. So generally the fluorescence none costs you higher. So you can go for triple X, 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 X fluorescence none. A fluorescence is medium is also okay. But sometimes one particular color emitting is considered very auspicious and sometimes those diamonds are also priced higher. What I'm trying to say is just know what you are getting into. Become smart. Educate yourself when buying a solitaire because it will make a huge difference knowing what you are buying and how much amount you are paying. And you will not have this feeling, I don't know why somebody is charging me X, somebody is charging me 2X, somebody is charging me 3X. You will exactly know what you are getting into. Thank you for watching.